Greetings and welcome to another excellent World of Tanks video. Bernie and I are here in Live Oaks, and I thought this would be just another regular long-haul type mission. But apparently, that wasn't in the cards. So, I'm going to show you what happened. Because what you're going to see here is something you don't normally see. And this will be a great video for guys to see so that they can compare their skills versus what you're about to see. First from myself and then from Bernie. So me, you know, I'm artillery, obviously. Bernie is running a Thresher. And this is a all tier 3 match. So, you know, it's a fair matchup. Nobody is outgunning anybody else. Which is rare, but they do happen. Usually you'll see those in, you know, tier 3 and tier 4. And sometimes tier 2s, but hardly anywhere else. Myself, as usual, I'm here taking shots of opportunity. That was a hit. That's another hit. That was not a hit. That is not a hit. That might be, I can't tell. I mean, I had a decent game. But you'll see at the end, that's where the real money is made. And what the end will show you is the just, you know, span of skills you have to become a game finishing winner. And you're gonna get to see not all of them, but almost all. You're gonna get to see a slice of this and a slice of that. It's really unbelievable stuff. Nice, that was a big hit right there. But this map is kind of annoying for artillery just because of the openness. And what makes it worse is the fact that, you know, the people on my team, the handful, that guy made an unbelievably good luck shot. They don't know how to defend people. And so I have to go over here to be defended against, you know, crazy stuff. No, robot, Bernie. So Bernie is here with three robot idiots. He's by himself. He's the last man standing. The three robots don't count. They're gonna die. What a shocker. Our team was trash, which you can see there. And so, well, I mean, he had a kill here, kill there, but nobody was doing anything of any real value outside of myself and Bernie, right? Two kills. Yeah, everybody else was one or zero, which is relatively standard. So what Bernie is doing, and he's executing sequences to win this game. There's six guys that he's facing along with this other robot, but that other robot doesn't last long. All right, so now it's 5-1. This is what you call Kolobanov territory. You're down 5-1 or more. It could be 6 or 7. And if you can pull this out, you get the Kolobanov medal. If you don't have a Kolobanov's medal, this game is super important to study. What Bernie has to do is get matchups, preferably one-on-one like this guy, and execute those matchups in his favor without being hammered by artillery. So he was staying primarily in the shadow of the bridge, the trestle, to keep artillery from raining shots on him as much as possible. He was like, he asking me, is this going to work? I go, probably. It's going to make it really hard for the artillery to shoot you depending on where he is. Which normally you're going to look and say he's ballpark of the enemy circle. Let's find out where is the artillery. Let's go look. Here we can look and see. He is right by the circle. So we were correct. That's where we assumed he had to be, because he wasn't able to get shots at Bernie. And what's going to happen here, we discussed this and he agreed with my idea, is that basically speaking, he doesn't have any troubles winning this match, because with what he did, he got a one-on-one and then a one-on-one and killed two guys with a one-on-one. He's going to get one-on-ones with each of these robot guys, two more robots and the artillery. And he'll execute the robots one-on-one because he far exceeds the ability of the robot to be killed. So he'll crush them. He just keeps on the move, keeping the artillery chances low. This is the best you can do. I mean, if the artillery guess is correct, he could kill him. Every artillery player has killed a guy like Bernie in a matchup like that. But it's rare. No matter how good you are, it's rare. So he stays on the move, one-on-one, he killed that guy, he's going to kill the next one when he finds him, and that's the whole point, and he's going to have a final showdown with the artillery, and man, easy money. Bernie goes, I got 5 shots left. I'm like, okay. I go, this is no problem. I told him what he's going to have to do is he's going to have to execute the strategy I'm going to tell you. But before I tell you, I have to remind you, the thing that my dad just pounded is you have to know how to win the game you're playing. And in the game he's playing an artillery with a slow reload. So basically speaking, Bernie, all he has to do is spot this artillery and then close in on him. He doesn't even have to fire a shot. Because at some point, the artillery is going to fire his shot, and he has over a 9-second reload. And so when that happens, he closes in during the 9 seconds. And once he gets in, he'll get behind him because he's more mobile than the artillery. So he'll beat the artillery, not with his gun, really, but with his mobility. The gun is the final piece of the puzzle. But the actual positional win occurs with the mobility. I told him, don't avoid the circle, go in the circle. You dare him to show his face to defend this base. Because if the artillery shows up to defend the base, he's going to get killed, and the artillery knew it. So he goes into the base, daring this guy, because artilleries have a really bad target acquisition and firing timeline. They acquire the target without a spotter on their own, meaning they're in range to be shot. And it takes a couple of seconds to get that shot to close down to where you can have a reasonable shot at him. I go, you'll butcher him. So, and in fact, I said the smartest thing he could do is just to not challenge you. Just lose on the base capture without dying. So you got to know how to win this battle. You don't have to kill him. You have to be prepared to kill him. 5 bullets is plenty of bullets to kill that artillery for Bernie, because he doesn't have to fire until he's behind him. And once you know that, it's in the bag. Because once he gets inside that reload time, he'll get in there to his side and then get behind him, and it's all over. Now here, it's a low percentage shot if Bernie is parked that he could be hit by the artillery. It's a slightly lower percentage shot for him to be hit while on the move, completely blind. You know, it might be a 1 in 100 shot that he hits him you know, if he's static, it's probably 1 in 1,000 on a moving shot where he's not giving a visual cue to the artillery. He's just randomly firing. So a magnificent performance by Bernie, because he was aware of every aspect on his own already, because he has that kind of skill. My job in this situation as his advisor is simply to tell him my perspective, so that if there's anything he's forgotten, you know, it's just, I'm just there to remind him of things, to make him aware of what he needs to do, so he has a great idea. You know, we're not, we, all of our dudes are like this. If we're dead and we're in the coaching chair, I'm in the coaching chair telling him things that he should be doing in general. And this is not, we don't do this to be the boss. It's just that we have different eyes, and it's good to have the perspective of another player telling you, hey, well, you need to do X, Y, Z. And it's like, yeah, that's correct. So, you know, we're on the same page. And there's no surprises, because it's much better to tell somebody how he needs to win the match and have him already know it and go, yes, I got this, no problem, than to say, I forgot about fill in the blank. Because in the heat of battle, you forget about things that you would think you don't forget. Trust me, it happens. I was playing in a game last night with Fish and Wrongway, and Wrongway was dead, and I was in a Valentine sniper, and he's like, there's a guy over there, you know, back up. I told him, man, I couldn't see the guy you're saying. All I did was listen to you, because I knew you knew something that I didn't know. So he was telling me what to do to save my life, and I was glad that he did it, because I lived that game. And that's the key. You have these guys, they do this for you. I do it for him, he does it for me, I did it for Bernie. Advisors. We're advisors to try and help the guy win, because we know that the guy who wins it is the guy in the tank. But if you can help him in any way, being the winner in the tank, you're like, dude, thanks for the help. You know, so it's one of those things. Learn how to execute the winning procedure. This is the key. Some cases, like this game, we had the original procedure that we thought was going to happen was going to be the confrontation, which didn't happen. The guy was smart, and he avoided Bernie because he knew that that was a losing proposition. Okay, so we have to recognize the opponent was smart and did a smart thing. He took a chance that was going to probably lose, but he would live, versus he's going to die. Barring a miracle, he was going to take a miracle either way. He would have to have a miracle shot from the other base, and if he fails that miracle, he still lives. Or he could go and get a miracle shot against Bernie head to head, and then if it doesn't work, he's going to die. So you see, both solutions represent a miracle to win for the artillery. But in one of those cases, the failed miracle, he lives, and the other failed miracle, he dies. He chose, realistically, in the real world, the best solution, because he still lives at the end of the war. That's the difference, okay? So that's what I wanted to let you know about this awesome game. That's Bernie, MVP, me, second place, and the artillery guy in third place, because we were clearly the three best players. So that was kind of cool, too. Here we are at Bernie's stats. These are the ones that count. So as you see, 7 kills, 1,675 damage, outstanding, really. 12,000 commander points. Also excellent, but this commander is a 9 skill commander. He's maxed out, so that doesn't really matter in this point. But a fantastic performance. Also, you know, best in game kills, obviously best in game blocked. Another, you know, 256 assist points. Just an overall fantastic game. That's a 1,900-plus combined score. This is the Kolobanov medal screen. So Bernie got the Kolobanov medal, as you can see, awarded to a player who stands alone against five or more enemy vehicles and wins. Doesn't have to kill them all. He just has to win. He killed four of them. The fifth one was still alive when he captured the base. So that's the key. You don't have to kill them all. Normally you think, well, I'm going to have to kill them all, but that's not really true. So you got the next badge is the invader badge for capturing the points on the base. Fire for effect is do more damage than your hit points. Check on that one. The diamond shape is the bruiser for knocking out crew members or modules. The sword is the top gun for killing six guys or more. He killed seven, so that's it. And then he got a second class badge. And literally a fantastic game, because it wasn't looking numerically good after I died. You know, and that's what happens. Guy makes a great shot, killed me. You can't complain, because it was just a great shot, okay? So you got to deal with it. And I deal with it by helping Bernie with advice as much as possible. And the rest was up to him. And, man, he finished that game off like a champion. So you might want to leave a comment for Bernie, because that's awesome. Because what he did was showed you how to finish a game. He made every fight at the end a one-on-one, crushing each guy in sequence. And then when he gets to the final one against the artillery, he didn't fight him head-to-head because the guy wouldn't let him because he was smart. But he did beat him positionally. And that was just really fantastic. So Bernie, A-plus game all the way. I told him I wanted to make a video of this because so many players could benefit by watching Bernie at work getting the Kolobanov medal, showing you what it's like in a regular tank. Yeah, I mean, a few days ago, I did the one in artillery, which is a completely different beast. The artillery Kolobanov is different than a regular tank one. And man, this was just an A-plus performance in every way. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video and got to really understand what Bernie was doing, because he was doing a fantastic job in this game. It would help if you could leave a like to help spread the word. Tell your friends, because they need to see this. They need to learn, you know, from a master to how to close out a game. And then, well, maybe they'll like and or subscribe. You never know. So I want to thank you guys for watching the video, as always. Look forward to seeing you guys again in a future video. And whenever you're here, I'll be here, and it'll be killer. So look forward to seeing you then. Thanks a lot. I'm out.